Let us now turn to our economic status and our prospects. In spite of headwinds that we have faced, we have stayed the course. The country exhibits healthy signs of post-pandemic resilience comparable to strong economies in our region. Our poverty rate has significantly dropped to 15.5%, down from 18% in 2021. This present figure is even lower than the pre-pandemic level of 16.7% in 2018. Ang katumbas nito ay halos 2.5 milyong Pilipino ang naiangat natin mula sa kahirapan. Kasabay nito, nabawasan ng lagpas 1,700,000 ang bilang ng mga Pilipinong walang sapat na pambili ng pagkain. Patuloy natin pagsisikapan na marami pa tayong maiaahon mula sa kahirapan. To sustain the country's economic gains, we are promoting investment-led growth. We have set in motion policies and programs to create an environment conducive for business to thrive, like reforms in the capital markets and implementation of green lanes. As a result, we have green lanes certified around 100 projects with a total investment of about 3 trillion pesos across the sectors of renewable energy, digital infrastructure, food security, and manufacturing. The Philippine financial system remains robust and resilient. Tax and non-tax revenue collection has also become more efficient in pace with our rejuvenated economy. Notably, for the past 2 years, our GOCCs have remitted dividends to the national government with a combined tally exceeding their contributions in 2022. To build on these, and guided by strong fiscal discipline, our proposed government budget for this year was crafted with utmost care, diligence, and meticulous attention. We look to the cooperation of our colleagues in the legislature, not only that our proposed national budget be approved in your usual timely manner, but it be adhered to as closely as possible. We expect all agencies to ensure that every centavo allocated will be judiciously spent for our urgent priorities and socially impactful programs. Mga kababayan, sa lahat ng ginagawa natin ito at mga gagawin pa, mataas ang aking kumpiyansa na malalampasan din natin ang hamon ng ating pinagdadaanan. Dahil ito ang pangunahing hinain ng taong bayan. Hindi tayo titigil sa paglalaban sa kahirapan at sa paghahanap ng lunas upang maibalik sa normal ang presyo ng bilihin, lalo na ang bigas. At ngayon po, naririnig po namin ang malakas na sigaw ng taong bayan laban sa mga pogo. Disguising as legitimate entities, their operations have ventured into illicit areas furthest from gaming, such as financial scamming, money laundering, prostitution, human trafficking, kidnapping, brutal torture, even murder. The grave abuse and disrespect to our system of laws must stop. Kailangan nang itigil ang panggulo nito sa ating lipunan at paglalapastangan sa ating bansa.